Welcome back to The Witcher 3. To continue the main quest, we need to meet Yennefer on Hindarsfjall. Hope I pronounced that right. Which is a small, well, relatively small island over here to the east. And I want to sail there. I think it's going to be fun sailing the stormy seas. Taking in the sights. I also want to stop by here, see what this question mark is. And who knows, there could be some stuff on these other islands, too, just unmarked. So let's go to the nearest boat. Looks like these are pretty close to each other, but this one's next to a really small town, so let's go here. There could be a quest or something in this town. Actually, I think that might be a bunch of ruins rather than an actual town. Or a village. Yeah, it's probably uninhabited, but regardless. Let's go check it out. Come on, Roach. Time to scurry.
Come on, Roach.
Ooh. Those are sirens, right? What are sirens again? They're hybrids. Yes, they're hybrids. Oh, those aren't sirens.
What?
Something
lost
else.
Your nerve?
That is the wrong sword. Okay, these are strange to fight. It seems like they don't naturally come to the ground, so I think I have to shoot them down. Well, this is awkward. Finally got one. Oh my god, these things are so annoying to fight! Is that it? Thank God. Drowners. Hey, wait a minute. I've got the wrong steel weapon on. When did that happen? Yeah, that should have been my kitty cat blade.
Thank you.
I'm just gonna run the rest of the way on foot. Ha! Is that a mountain goat? Well, it's a goat in the mountains. And given the steepness of what it's climbing on, I think it's gotta be a mountain goat. Oh, look at these snow-covered hills. So pretty. Calm down, goat. Everything is fine. Red Gill. Oh, maybe this place is inhabited. It's actually got a fast travel post. Yeah, it looks pretty wrecked to me. Anybody here? Not a soul here. Let's go sailing. Ah, right, first place to the question mark. Look at these stormy seas. Ah, beautiful. I think there's a crashed ship on this little island here. Probably ran into it during a storm. More of these things. Also want to make sure I don't wreck my boat here, or I'm going to have to swim all the way back. Oh, come on. Come on. There we go. I don't think I've ever manually aimed this before. Come on, fight me! Fight me, fight me, fight me! Looks like the treasure's underwater. Yep. Mostly crafting stuff and a piece of armor. You know, I never get tired of saying how beautiful this game is. Look at that. Everything, the waves, the mountaintops, the sky, the rain, the sun, and the sun shafts. The ripple of the sail. Undulations of the sea. Just beautiful. It's medium armor. And worse than my light armor, too. Okay, do I go straight to my destination, or hit some of the islands? Let's go to the islands. Well, that one's kind of out of the way. Let's go to this one, because that's pretty much along the way. This one first, and then this one. I can actually pilot the boat and use my item. Oh, I was gonna wonder if I could use my torch at the same time because that'd look cool, but I can't. I can't select it, it's grayed out. But you can use your crossbow. I wonder if they'd attack me while I'm in my boat. Because that'd be a problem. Can I even get up here? I guess I can just fight them on my boat. And now, okay, cool. You know what? I don't think there's anything on this island. And I can't really do the movement the way I normally do when I'm in combat, so I can't really get off the boat properly. Oh crap. I actually can't even repilot the boat until I've taken care of the enemies. Shit. Wait, maybe I can. Oh, I was just looking on the wrong side. Actually, I can. Let's go. Yeah, there's nothing on top of there. And there's probably nothing on the other one either. Let's go to our destination. Here's something. Thank you. horrible place to fight. Gee, no, don't swim, Geralt. I haven't heard this battle music before. It's really good. There we go. That was not a hard fight, but man, was it annoying. Notes of a Pirate. Yeah, one issue you run into fighting people, or fighting creatures on a place like this, is that when you're actually in combat, you can't climb stuff like you normally can. So for example, like right now, if I just walk up to this, press space, it just grapples over it. Or, is grapple the right word? Vaults over it, whatever you want to call it. So I could easily just get over this thing when I'm outside of combat, but if you're in combat, you can't do that. Instead of space doing this kind of move, instead space will be a roll. So I can't actually get over this thing properly when I'm in combat, so when one of these creatures falls inside of the boat or on the other side of the boat, and I'm in combat, I can't actually get over to it to try to finish it off. So it's pretty frustrating. Okay, Notes of a Pirate. Hauled in a mighty fine catch this time. 7 women and 10 men, each healthy and strong. Top quality goods. Captain doesn't know yet where we'll sell them, but for merchandise like this, we're sure to get a good price anywhere. Perhaps we'll sail to... illegible. There's this one we've got who's damned pretty, but a damned pain in the ass, too. If not for that, I'd keep her for myself. But when she's not bawling her eyes out, she's yelling threats at us. Demands we let her go or drop her off at Freya's temple. And that if we don't, her brother will sail after her and slaughter us all. Now that'd be the day when... something something. First 3 days at sea were quiet, but now a storm's blowing in. Blasted Skellige weather. Why couldn't I just wait till we left these waters? And then they crashed and got killed by these creatures. Oh, there's Yennefer. Waiting for me at the docks. Hold on, though. I need to repair my silver sword. Yeah, it's at 38%. Let's get it to 100%. There we go. Also, let's meditate to get our stuff back. Also, there's a bunch of wolves that are... like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 wolves? Yennefer? Yennefer, you might want to turn around. That one's, like, grazing her feet. It's howling inches behind her. She does not care. White wolves. Oh, you're so beautiful, I don't want to kill you! Shit, 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 this is bad, this is really, 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 really bad! I need bombs. I need bombs. Moondust, good, my grape shots are good. Let's get rid of moondust, that's definitely not useful. But yeah, these, there's too many for me to manage. Grape shot is what I need. Okay, there's one left. We're good. They really are beautiful creatures. Now we really need our stuff back. And she just watched while I got attacked by a group of wolves. A murderous pack of white wolves. You didn't even lift a finger, Yennefer. How rude.
Greetings, Yen.
Good thing you're here. The frostbite was starting to set in.
You should have dressed warmer.
Next you'll be pinning mittens to my coat. Can we go?
Yeah.
Quite a few years since I was last on Hindarsfjall. But if I remember correctly, Lofoten should be this way.
I'm telling her she should dress warmer, but I don't even have long sleeves. My arms are completely exposed.
Gathering of some kind. We've come at a bad time.
There's no good time to talk about the wild hunt.
What if Crazen told the truth? In the grind, they what if he didn't abandon us? It was...
Stop!
He was our
perhaps
brother.
Were written in the stars.
He sailed on the same longship, sat oar to
oar, has grown red in the black ones together.
But we're dead.
Ritual of some kind. We'll have to wait.
We'll do no such thing. Dear sisters, pardon the interruption, but we've an important matter to discuss.
Can you not see we're commemorating the dead? So.
And we're looking for someone who's still alive. Please, this is urgent. Then speak.
They say the wild hunt destroyed this village.
That is true, though few believe us. You don't either, I'm sure. Did you see riders on skeletal horses, wearing frost-covered armor?
Aye, that's how it was. They landed on our shores in a ship made of the claws of dead men, like in the ballads. Leif yelled to grab the children. Then they came, cut him across his face. He tried to whisper, only blood came out.
You were to ask about someone, not prod their wounds.
That's enough. What happened then?
Go on.
I ran out. To get help. To get Leif. But so many bodies. Jolle. Ingvar. Little Neggy.
Which way did the riders go?
Towards the sea. Through the ravine. On horses made of bones. Bones and ice and...
Enough!
Get to the point. Now.
We're looking for a young woman. Name of Ciri. Ashen hair, green eyes.
I'm sorry. She is not here.
Unless she lies in a grave. That is, I do not recall one by that name. But I've buried so many, I may have forgotten.
This Ciri. Has she a scar here on her cheek?
Yes. Yes, what happened to her?
Don't know. Saw her but for a moment, right before it all. She was in the stables with Craven. A thousand curses upon him.
Remember anything else? Anything at all?
Only that she seemed tired. Very tired. And her hair was wet.
Great. So we know she bathed. Progress.
I'm sorry,
Craven!
My apologies. Craven. Craven could have told you more.
Could have? Does that mean Craven's dead?
This Craven you mentioned, does he have a name?
He did. Until the Elders struck him from the Saga of Ancestors.
It's as if he has ceased to exist. The lore forbids anyone from touching him, speaking to him, even uttering his name.
What did he do to deserve that?
He fled from the Wild Hunt. He alone.
We need to talk to him, even if it's not in keeping with your customs.
You've come too late. He went to the garden to fight Morkvag.
To fight what?
A coward who willingly seeks battle? Am I the only one who sees the contradiction?
That's why he did it. Craven knew he would prove the Elders wrong only if he killed Morkvarg.
And thus regain his honor and his name.
Trial by ordeal. Very Skellige.
I do not mock your lores. Please also respect ours.
Where is this holy garden?
Not far from here. North. We cultivated healing herbs there once.
And now?
Now we walk only as far as the tree the goddess planted. We place our offerings and make our pleas before it.
Those who venture below remain in the garden forever.
Morkvarg. What's that?
Who, you mean?
The vilest man ever to inhabit Skellige. Nothing was ever sacred to him. He attacked his own clan's lands, took gold from Nilfgaard, killed children, pregnant women.
Know the type.
They said he feared only one thing, the wrath of the gods. Morkvarg sought to prove how wrong they were, so he sailed to Hindarsfjall to ransack the goddess's garden. This was over a decade ago.
Archpriestess Ulva stood in his way. He thrust a blade between her ribs and cast her down in the mud. As her lifeblood left her, she cursed him, and Morkvarg transformed into a beast.
A curse? A monster? You've got some work to do.
I can get rid of Morkvarg. Don't know what he's turned into, but a silver sword should do the trick.
It's not that simple. There have been those who have bested Morkvarg, yet he always returns.
So, it's a complex curse. Meaning I need more information.
I understand. But I've told you all I know.
Speak with Toradar's son, Einar. He was in the garden when Morkvarg and his men attacked. He saw what happened. Of all the pilgrims there at the time, he alone escaped with his life. He settled in Larvik. You'll find him there at the landing, provided he's not out to sea when you arrive.
Thanks for your help.
I understand you intend to enter the garden. I dislike it when foreigners enter the sacred grounds, but so be it.
Custom demands pilgrims make an offering of their own blood before the tree. Craven surely did so. Unless he lacked not only courage, but respect for Freyr as well.
You needn't worry about us. Geralt and I always give the gods the respect they are due.
Yes. Of course we do.
Morgan, what are you going to do in this big house?
Let me get rid of this marker that I've got on the map. There we go.
You're alone.
Worried this trail might have gone cold.
Even if Craven's dead, we'll manage. Hey, Geralt, come back.
You come to me. I'm following the GPS.
One morsel. One piece. a crumb. Fade. Fade. Shank! Not again! Not again!
Jesus Christ.
He doesn't seem happy to see us.
Wait till he gets a closer look at me.
Now, hold on, wasn't I supposed to go to somebody to find more information? Wasn't I supposed to gather information from the guy? It doesn't seem to be in the quest, though. Alright.
So, where should we start?
Let's go to that tree the sisters mentioned.
Plan to bleed yourself for the goddess?
Not necessarily, but Craven did. We just might pick up his scent. Craven was here. Look, the impression. Kneeled down on one knee, and cut himself to make the offering. Bloodstains, see them?
No. I may be inhumanly beautiful, but I don't have superhuman senses. Not like you.
Which is why you should stay up here. No offense, but in that undergrowth and mud, you'd be like a...
ball and chain?
Planned to say it gentler, but yeah, that's basically what I had in mind.
Fine. We'll do as you say. If the need arises, I can cast spells from up here.
Thought you might object.
Me? Please. I can be extraordinarily conciliatory.
Yen, look me in the eye. What are you plotting?
Many things. How to seize the Temerian crown, how to sell Kaer Morhen out from under you. Go already!
How in the hell would she be a ball and chain down in the mud? She's a freaking mage. I'm sure she could be helpful.
Craven's blood, flowing profusely. Trail's clear. Should lead me to him. Light prints. Craven trod carefully.
They lead down here. Mm-hmm.
No bite marks. Morkvark doesn't eat his victims. Strange.
Is it Craven?
No, this one's been here a while.
What? I can't hear you. If you want to chat, come closer.
Monster tracks. Running. Chasing something.
Well, what is it?
I found a corpse. Not Craven's, though.
Uh-huh. And you thought I'd find this interesting because...
Because? No bite marks on it. Doesn't seem strange to you?
Zerikanian cuisine, dandelion's fame, and shoes with curly toes seem strange to me, yet I don't discuss them with you.
Reading between the lines here, think I'm wasting your time?
I mean merely that we should focus on what's most important at the moment.
Okay, well, in that case...
All right, going back down.
Be careful.
I just won't say anything to you.
Looks like Morkvark got bored of sneaking around. Attacked.
Wolves are so fast, it's actually really hard to avoid getting hit. Nostrix. I just picked up some Nostrix. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Let's make more of a concerted effort to actually pick the herbs here. Could be some rare stuff.
Craven's blood. Morkvog doesn't give up easily. Morkvog doesn't give up easily.
Need a key. I can't break this, can I?
Yes.
I guess I can't even say anything to her. So it's up to me to find the key. There's an examine it thing. Keeps popping up for like half a second. Ah, forget it. Ah, I can't go this way either.
Another corpse. No bite marks here either. Lots of prints, old and new. His lair must be nearby.
Ah, there's a little ladder. And what is this behind this bush? A print? It's like a little waterfall over there. Ah, that must be his lair.
Can't cross that. Gotta go down, provided I can open the sluice. Mechanism looks pretty standard. One lever to choose the sluice gate, the other to work it.
Wait, I'm sorry, what can I not reach? I don't see anything that I shouldn't be able to reach just by jumping or running. So it picks from one of three sluice gates. I've got the middle one selected. Whatever that means. Yeah. I did stuff. I mean, I guess I'm just supposed to swim through the gate that's been opened? But if that's where I'm supposed to go, then what the heck is up here? And also over there. Because this looks like the lair.
Key? Ramond? Where's the key? All I have in the chapter house, the crate, but the key, where's the key? Why so silent, Ramond? You thief, you rogue, you whoreson, you worthless bastard! I will find the key without you, idiot, stupid prick!
Okay, whoa. So I can defeat you, but it sounds like you always, they always come back, so even if I defeat them, it's probably not gonna matter. But for now, I do need to defeat them, so let's put on some cursed oil.
Makes me bite, scratch, mangle, till I drop. You've got time before the blood's gone from me, and I return. Listen, carefully. Undo the curse. Free me. Finally, I will reward you.
Looking for a man named Craven. Apparently came here to kill you.
Seems it didn't work out. Those who come rarely introduce themselves. What did he look like?
No idea.
Then I cannot help you. I've shredded many.
So, no joy in being a werewolf?
Nay. It's the worst. Not the garden to which I'm bound, even. But the hunger. Anything I devour turns to ash. Ash I cannot eat. I cannot drink, yet I bloody live and roam and prowl. The hunger is terrible. I bite my own flesh, but the smallest morsel burns my throat. Like boiling tar.
Everlasting hunger, classic as curses go. Goes to explain why all those corpses went untouched.
Help, or I'll return to shred you, rip you limb from limb.
See what I can do.
See and do, or I shall return.
Tiresome conversation. Not interested.
What will you do?
What a Witcher ought to.
Not sure why Geralt said it was a tiresome conversation. I didn't actually mean for it to be like that. I thought I just had to kill him. I mean, I know he's gonna come back, but... am I supposed to just let him bleed to death? I guess I could've. What a sad, sad, sick creature. He's obviously a horrible person, but that curse is fucked up. Not to mention, the curse gets more people killed. Anybody who ventures here is gonna get... is going to and has been mauled to death by him. Regardless of whether I like him or not, or want to help him or not, I need to free the curse.
Draft from below. A cave?
In wolf's clothing. Talk to Einar about the curse. Oh! It's a separate quest! Huh. Whoops. I guess I kinda messed up then. Cause I think I need to go all the way back to town to talk to the person.
Ideal friend. Patient, doesn't mouth off.
So can I actually complete the main quest here without doing the In Wolf's Clothing quest? Because In Wolf's Clothing is not a main quest. Yeah, it's not a main quest. Okay, well, I feel like this is gonna take a while, so I think I'll end it here. Not only do I need to find more information about the curse so that I can lift it, but I also still need to find Craven, and explore the rest of the herbarium. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.